and welcome to Tonic Studios.
Subscribe to our mailing list to keep up to date with all the latest Tonic Studios news. Tag us in your mix. We love to see what you're making. Subscribe to the Tonic Craft Kit
for 10% off every order.
Never miss a video from us. Like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. Question for our crafters? Let us know in the comments.
You can find us on Facebook,
Instagram, and YouTube. No. Hello and welcome to Tonic Studios.
Alison, sorry, I forgot to switch the cameras off.
Technical issues already. It's going to be a great evening.
So I feel it in my waters.
Welcome on in. We are in the basement again. Alison and I are here, along with, of course, the voice behind the camera, the lovely Mr. Alex.
Hello. Hi, everyone. Hello.
And we're down here in the basement. We are doing our craft clinic at our new and possibly improved time of 6 p.m. on a Wednesday.
Tell us, is it better for you?
Does this work for you? Is it a good time for you to join us with your crafty questions? Do let us know. I can see we've got lots of people joining us already. It is lovely to see you all here. So hello to Sue, nice to see you. Sharon, thank you very much for the cuppas.
Oh, I think we absolutely.
Appreciate them today. I've been up for too many hours at this point. It's been a very long day, so I could probably use a good
There's nothing
coffee.
Like a Sharon coffee, I gotta say
no,
that.
Absolutely not. Who else have we got here? Verna, nice to see you here. And Holly and Julie. Hi, Rachel as well. So welcome on in, everyone. Do say hi. Let us know where you're watching from.
Yeah.
If you have any questions at all, let us know. We'd love to answer your questions live for you while we are here.
If we can, we will. If we can't, then it'll be our next month's
exactly.
show.
We'll go away, do some research and come back.
We don't know everything.
We don't. We don't profess to know everything.
Oh, absolutely not.
Definitely not. Ruth is watching as well. Hi there, Ruth.
Hello, Ruth.
And Lizzie. Hello.
Hello everyone.
And Anya as well, so welcome on in. We have lots of things to talk about today. We've been going through loads of old videos and Facebook posts trying to find as many different crafty questions as we could.
We're going to be novo-y today, I think, haven't we?
It's going to be a bit of a messy... We've had a bit of a messy day, to be honest. If you could see everything that was to Alison's side, we've been having lots of
Shall
fun with shimmer powder.
Shall I bring a little bit in?
Oh, I think we should. Look
we've
been
these.
Having oh. lots and lots of fun with shimmer powder down here.
Look at that.
You might have spotted me recently in my lovely orange apron.
If you've never tried shimmer powder, it was freebie in the last kit, but they're also available on the website.
And so many beautiful colours as well.
Look at these. Look at them. There's some plain colours.
And all that gorgeous shimmer. I love the mica stuff.
The other one I was going to show, look at these two. I know, I'm going to bring them all in now. I'll have a lot in a pile by you.
Tonight we're talking about shimmer powder.
We're not, actually.
We're not at all, no.
No, we've got all these because Leo's done one of her, or has recorded one of her patented complete guide tos. So look out for that in the next couple of days. So
in-depth look.
Absolutely. You know, if you're a bit frightened of them, Leo will have the answer for you. So this is Somewhere. Just sprinkling onto a page.
Yep.
If you have, I'm going to bring one in here. You know the little glitter misters? Oh, as I check it everywhere. Let me bring that forward. Look at that. They amazed me when I first tried them. Absolutely amazed me. So
what we've been filming today has just been, to steal you a word, alchemy.
It is.
It's been so fun to watch.
I hope you're going to really enjoy seeing that because we've spent a lot of time
down
here today. The orange apron has been on most of the day. It's been a good fun.
I won't show any more secrets.
No, exactly. We'll have to keep something for the video. I want people to come back.
Absolutely.
So yeah, if you are not already subscribed to our channel, make sure that you are so that when that video drops, you will get a notification, a little notification bell, ding that.
Absolutely.
And you'll be the first to see that lovely shimmer powder video.
We've got a good evening there. Anya. Oh, that's Anya.
Anya, yeah. We've got
Jill.
Holly is saying she's never used shimmer powder and she doesn't know how. Well, there we go.
You need to watch Leo's video.
Absolutely.
Definitely hit that notification bell, Holly.
Do that. Coming soon. I mean, I've done my part. I've filmed it. So we're all now waiting on Alex to edit it into some kind of masterpiece and put it together. So
we've got a few little bits of shimmer powder, though, haven't we? We've got that video. We've got a couple with a kit.
Yeah.
So you'll have lots of ideas.
Lots and lots of information on shimmer powder coming your way very, very soon.
Should we go on to our first question?
Let's.
Right then.
We've got some fun ones today. I'm looking forward to this.
Okie dokie. So I've got a question from Lynn Heald, and this was on YouTube. For the card shown on the Fantasy Floral Frames reveal video, what size is the base card and where do you score it? So I'm a big fan of card folds.
Mm-hmm.
What about you? Are you a card fold fan? What's your favourite card fold?
I thought you were talking to me.
Are you a fan?
Yes. Do you like card fold, Alex? Is that your preferred method?
So this was the card I made. It's a simple card fold. So, now let me bring it forward.
And to the side, well done.
There we are, I've got it now. I like to hug everything, that's my problem, see? So it's a really simple card fold, but I think it's an effective one as well. You put half on the inside of the card, half on the outside.
I love it.
So, what have I done? I have taken a 6x6, there we are, one of our 6x6 cards. I don't know if you know it, but sometimes when you buy cardstock, they say 6x6, but it's the envelope, the 6x6. If you buy a tonic card set, the actual card is 6x6. Mm-hmm. So you may think that they don't fit in envelopes you've got, and that'll be the reason.
But we sell them, the card blanks and the envelopes together, so you'll always have the exact right
yes,
number of envelopes
will.
For your card blanks from us.
Yes, you will. So this is just a plain, bog standard square card. So it was so easy. Take your scoreboard, open your card out, and you can see it's right on my 6-inch line. So the only thing I want to do is score at 3 inches. So basically the answer for Lynn is it's a 6x6 card. You score at 3 inches, and that is your card base. And this could be for anything, any layering die set you've got that's going to fit on this size, or you go down smaller sizes, that is the perfect card for you. So put some layers inside, put the smaller layers on the front, and you've got a nice card.
It's a lovely, effective card to use. Would you call it a fold back card?
I would call it a fold back.
Yeah.
A fold back, I would. So if you want to create a card, let's go down that way. Oh, he's confusing me now. If you want to do...
You're lightning fast with what you're swapping. Can't keep up.
It's not often I'm told I'm lightning faster.
No.
Certainly not in the brain department at the moment. So if you want to create a card like this, that is how you do it. Come forward a bit.
Have we done one of those recently with an aperture cut into it?
We may have.
For the one that had the dragonflies on it, the die set that had dragonflies on it.
Oh, I think yes, I think we did. Dragonflies and
we did.
Dandelions, was it?
But you know, what's your favourite card fold? Let us know.
We have posted on the Tonic Studios Facebook group today.
Yes, we have.
We have actually listed a poll. We're asking you what your favourite size of card bases is. So if you're making cards for people and sending them out, what kind of size cards are you doing at the moment? Are you an A2, an A6? Do you like a square, a 6x6, a 7x7, an 8x8, 9x9 even? You know, how
Absolutely.
Big do you go? What is your favourite card size at the moment?
Mine's a 6x6 and a 5x7. I can't just have one. I've got a two. No. What's yours?
A5, straight away.
Is it really?
A5, because I don't know, it's just something that I got into when I first started crafting, half a sheet of A4, fold it in half, and it's all of my layers now I know based off that, so that's what I tend to do. Although, that being said, I do a lot of A2 cards.
You do? That's what I thought you were going to say, was an A2.
I guess because I'm used to making my own card bases, so I just half a sheet of A4. I know it's nice and simple.
It is.
From one sheet, you get two card bases, and that's that done.
Nice.
Whereas I don't know the measurements for an A2 off the top of my head. It's only because we've got card blanks upstairs and I just use those. So
card blanks are handy to have, though.
Very handy. Very, very handy.
Especially a 6x6.
Mm.
Because you can't cut those out of an A4 card.
No, you can't.
You've got to make a slightly smaller one.
Yep.
Which is fine. But if you want the full A6, 6x6, then you need a card base.
Yep.
Or your 12x12
card. Or 12x12 card. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So we've got a couple of people chiming in on that. So Aisha is here. Welcome on in, Aisha. Nice to see you. And she said that 8x8, 6x6, and 7x7 are her favourite sizes.
Oh, nice. So you're definitely a square card.
Yeah, I was going to say. And then Suzanne Roth is saying that her favourites are 5x7 and a 6x6.
Nice.
So twins. Common sizes, it sounds like.
Yeah.
I guess I'm just all on my own with my A5 cards.
I'm sure there's lots. There'll be lots of people making A5s.
I'm sure, because it's a fairly common envelope size to be able to get as well.
Yes.
So
what have we got next? Mm. We've got another question. So I'm hoping I've got your name right. I think it's Skylo, and she's on YouTube as well. And she said, I hope you get to do a video on blending daubers and brushes. So I've kind of brought a bit of a selection.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's all well and good saying, we've got all these blenders and brushes. Why do we need them all? Do we need them all? Depends on what you make.
Mm-hmm.
So, let me show you what I've got first.
We had a lot of fun upstairs with this, didn't we? Fun
we did.
All of our blending tools we across did. The office.
So I've had a little rootle round. So, let me get them all out and then I can tell you all about them.
How much ink is on them?
I know. But then you keep one colour then for one set of colours.
Mm-hmm.
You can see I've got my pinks, I've got my teals, purples, greens.
So that would be probably a top tip, right? That
absolutely.
Obviously we sell the pads separately. And because when you put more ink onto a dauber, it's going to reactivate the ink that's already in the sponge. So if you tried to put pink ink on a blue sponge already,
you're going to get purples.
Exactly. That's what I'm
saying. And that may be what you want. That may be what you want. But it may not as well. And that may be your project ruined.
Exactly. So try and keep them separate if you can.
My tip as well is keep a separate one for white.
Mm-hmm.
I've made the mistake. I picked it up thinking there was no ink on it. And of course, when I started inking then, I thought, this colour is a bit strange. But there was white mixing in with it. So I always keep this in a plastic bag. There's my bag, well used.
Especially
so selected. I know I don't contaminate it with anything. And I keep a white dauber. Right. So what have we got here? Let's have a little look. So we have our bristle brushes. So we have the double-ended and we have the smaller version. We have our precision brushes. Are they precision? Yeah, is that what we call them?
Precision blending brushes.
What am I liking? And these come in a pack of various sizes. We also have our little sponge daubers. Then we have the bigger version. Oh, I love these. Mm-hmm. Look at these. That is so soft. It's almost like, I don't know, it feels like a baby skin to me, that does. It's gorgeous. And then we have two sorts of daubers. So we have the base and then you buy the top separate. So they'll come to you in a pack. You'll have some with the dauber. And then for refills then, they come in a pack on their own. So we have a flat top, like these, and we also have a dome top. So let's just do a little bit of playing now and show you what each of them does.
And you're going to get a different texture and different effect, aren't you, with
absolutely.
Each one?
Absolutely. Let's bring some card in. So I've got a piece of card and I've got a stencil. Well, here we are. Let's show this one first. So Leo did this. Leo had a little bit of a play with all the different brushes to see what effect we had, because we weren't really sure, were we?
No.
So we did the precision blending brush. You can see it's very, very smooth. You don't get any brush strokes in it. It's a really smooth pattern with it.
Mm-hmm.
The sponge then, you tended to have a little bit darker, a little bit lighter.
You kind of get more drag when you're using it because it is a sponge.
Yeah.
It just moves differently across the paper.
The blending brush.
That's your bristly one.
So that's these.
Mm-hmm.
Either one. And then you get a, you can do a stippling effect with that. But you can also see a little bit of a brush mark in the ink as well. I'm going to push that forward a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Then we had the two different blending daubers. So this was your flat one, so you can do some techniques with this. You can also blend in from the side of the page. But I found you had less edge marking with the domed one than you had with the flat one. So again, it depends on the technique you want.
Mm-hmm.
What style do you want? So then I thought, right, let's do a little bit with some stencils. Did I bring that one down? I think I did. I did. So I'll show you all of these. Let me show you with this one, it's easier. Show you with the stencil. I can explain everything then. So pop my stencil down. And the first one I'm going to take is the nice big blending brush. So what do we get with this? So what I want, what I'm hoping, is I'm going to have a nice, smooth effect. I'm not pressing very hard. And as I go over, you can see where I've started, so I've got a darker colour. The further out I'm going, I've got a lighter colour. Because obviously I've used up most of the ink over there.
Mm-hmm.
So that is quite, I'm hoping you're picking up. On TV. Are we picking that on the monitor?
Yeah.
Good. So I like that effect. And as you can see, it's gone into all the gaps on my page. So it's taken it right up to the edge of the stencil. I haven't got a huge stencil mark.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, they're quite small. So what would I do with the smaller brushes? These are your spot stenciling, I would say. So I want to pick out this little flower. So I'm going to go right in the center and I can almost put this exactly where I want it. And then you go over as much or as little as you want. So if I lift that up, you can see there's nothing really on the outer markings, just the flower in the center. That's why I love these. So if you're doing die cuts, you can pick out a small element. You can say, right, I want that in pink. And you can just stick to that one little area. So I think these are just, I can't live without these.
No. And they come in a couple of different shapes. So obviously you've got the round one, you've got a slightly sort of longer, flatter one, and there's a couple of different sizes in that shape. I don't think we had all of them available upstairs, unfortunately, to bring down. And then obviously you've got the bigger, smaller oval ones.
And then the big one and then the small one.
So different shapes, obviously, for different things, depending on where you want your ink to end up.
How big is your project? That's what you've got to ask yourself. How big is it?
Yeah, exactly.
You know, if you're making small A2 cards, then you may not need the biggest blender, and you certainly may not need that size, because this is going bigger. We're going bigger. We're going to cover more space with this one. But if you're making backgrounds for cards, this may be exactly what you need.
Exactly.
So I'm going to show you a different one now. So if I go with a sponge, I'll go on the bottom of this stencil. So I've got a little bit on my sponge. So what I found with this was it kind of, in areas, it picked up more colour. And then in other areas, there was less colour. But the stencil underneath was a bit more gappy than where I used the brush. So we had more of the white showing. And again, nothing wrong. That may be exactly what you want.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, it may well be you want to go over with another colour. So you may want the outer edges to be a different colour. Saying that, I may go a bit rogue here. I know.
She's going off piste, everybody.
I am, because I didn't do this upstairs.
Well.
So my centre here is the blue, and maybe if I go over the top, so it's going to change my colour completely. But the outer edges now are more green. The centres are more turquoise and the outer edges are more green. So you may need a mixture. Again, I found a similar thing with the blending brushes. The blending tools, sorry. If I go here. It was a very smooth effect. But again, I had quite a large white area. If I went in with the domed, I found the centre, let me move up by here a bit, the centre where, the centre of the cutout bit, that's what I'm trying to say, and I'm not saying it very well.
It's not like you are.
I know.
Like we said, it's been a long day.
But the centre had more colour. So when I lift that, there's a definition. The outer edges are paler. The centre has got more colour. But you've still got quite wide areas that have not been covered by the ink.
So yeah, it's not getting into kind of
it's
the
not
edges
getting
of
into
stencil.
The edge.
Yeah.
The other thing you may find with the sponges as well, if you go very hard up against your stencil, you're going to take little bits of sponge off. So I would keep my sponges more for
like your mousses, backgrounds and things like that.
Yes. Or coming in from the edge of your pages. That's what I would keep my sponges for. Put a bit more colour on, Al. You're being mean. That's where I would do it. Coming in from the edges. What about our brushes then? Because we haven't touched on these brushes yet. Let's move over. I've used up all our stencil.
Isn't it lucky we've got a big piece of paper?
I have a big one, yes. So it doesn't matter. These are similar. They are both bristle brushes. So again, it depends on how big your project is. Do you want to cover a big expanse or not? So when I use this one, I tend to go in a swirling motion. You will cover all the areas. If you don't hold your stencil down, you've got a risk that it goes underneath your stencil. And again, I've got a pretty even colour all around. But I can also stipple with these. And then you get a more, is that me?
Yeah. It's the table.
We've got metal shelves at the front of the desk.
We do apologise.
We should take them off, really. In fact, I can see what it is that's rattling.
So you can get a bit more of a texture just by stippling. Mm-hmm. And again, you can add more colours into this. So I think that's another nice effect. So I think they all give a different effect. Mm-hmm. The other thing I like to do, I'm going to bring in a little bit of a card here with the big brush, is I'll show you the two big brushes actually as a difference. You know, if you're creating a background, I like to see, I'm going to bring in a piece of white card behind this now. Just keep going over. But I like to see the darker colour on the edge. Mm-hmm. So if I turn that over, you can pick up the dark colour on the edge there. But you've still got a very soft pattern in the middle. And I think that is nice for a card base and your layers.
Yeah.
You can have a faux layer almost on the outside.
Exactly. You could even just use white card and a colour of ink.
Absolutely.
To build up your card, couldn't you?
Yeah. And if you keep going, then you can darken your colour. You can go from very light, one layer, mm-hmm. and then you add two or three layers to get a darker colour. So what would we do with this one then?
We have had a question from Danny Cariasso.
Hiya, Danny.
Who's asked if you can wash the daubers and reuse the dauber with a different colour.
You can wash them, but I think with the daubers, you get a pack of them. I don't know how many. There's 10 pads in one of these packs. With the flat ones, there's more. So I would just say keep one for each colour.
Not necessarily each individual colour, but like what each colour family. So one for reds, one for pinks, one for greens, one for purples. Yes. Unless you've got a particularly pale ink, and then probably you don't want a dark purple on a
yellow,
you know, lilac or something, because you're just going to end up with dark purple. So probably better to have the individual colours if you can. But yeah, absolutely wash them.
Maybe keep a pastel one if you can.
Yeah.
Your yellows, don't use anything else with your yellows. So this one has given me a much smoother effect. I've got no brush. I've got tiny brush strokes here. I don't think
it's just slightly more textured, isn't it?
It is slightly textured. And I like it. You know, if I'm doing a sunset, I like to have that bit of texture mm-hmm. in it. But this side is very, very smooth. Again, it's got the darker colour on the outer edge. Mm-hmm. What do you like doing with your inks?
Yeah, absolutely. And don't forget, all of these tools are not just for inks. You can use a lot of them with a load of our other
any of products. Our mousses.
Mousses, our pastes.
Yes.
I love using this little white sponge and glacier paste because you just get that hint of colour, but all of that beautiful mica just laid down on the page. That is one of my favourite techniques.
The other one I wanted to show you as well, a really quick one, and I know I've done this before. This is created... Oh, there we are, just with your daubers. So if you're thinking, well, I'm not very creative, you can create this. So what I've used in this, I've brought them all down. So I have used, and this could be any colours you've got. I've used Lime Burst, Royal Plum, Panama Rose. The one you will need is the white pigment, because that is what creates that mistiness over the top, and as it dries it just gets softer. Mm-hmm. I think that's a lovely background.
It is. You say bokeh and I say bokeh effect, and I don't know which is right.
I don't know.
It's bokeh.
Is it bokeh? Yeah, there you go.
It's the soft lights in the background of a shot that's out of focus.
Exactly bokeh. That
Hey, I know something.
Yay!
We've had this conversation before, haven't we?
Yes, and I was looking at Leo Funny then, mm-hmm. because I was trying to think, what video, we've done this in a video. What video was it?
Wouldn't
Can you remember?
It would have been
Alison. No, I'm Alison and myself.
It was.
What have we done? It was a Christmas one, wasn't it?
It was.
I mean, that would be perfect for the background for a Christmas card.
Absolutely.
You know, your Christmas lights.
Absolutely.
Nicely sort of out of focus in the background.
So if we try a domed, you kind of get a fuzzier outer edge. And that may be what you want. So if you were coming in from the outer edge and you don't want to see any harsh lines, that's your dome you need. Definitely. If you want the bokeh, whatever
pretty
it is.
Pretty background light
effect.
Your
pretty background is just done by dotting it. So there is nothing artistic. Just have fun.
Yeah, layer up your colours.
Most of you have got this stuff in your house.
Mm-hmm.
If you've bought kits, I think all this has come in a kit at one point. So if you haven't used it, maybe now is the time to have a bit of fun with it.
Yeah, so Aisha is actually saying that she loves the hybrid ink pads. And they're very cute, and they are absolutely, I love the little mini ones. She uses them through her stencils, and we need more in the craft kits, please. And
we definitely
couldn't agree more. Definitely.
We love a stencil.
We do. Something we've been talking about a lot recently.
Absolutely.
And keep your eyes peeled is all I'm going to say on that.
In fact, I had that conversation immediately before I came down here mm-hmm. tonight.
Yeah.
So hopefully that's given you a couple of ideas that you can do, like I say, with what you've got in your craft room. Have a little play. But don't forget, show us what you've made.
Yes, absolutely.
Tag us in your makes.
We love to see what you're up to. Are you an inky person? Do you like to make blended backgrounds or funky diffused light in the backgrounds? You know, what is your inky kind of go-to? Is there something that you do more than anything else?
If you're looking at that and you think, oh, it's a bit way out for me, I don't think I can do those colours, try pastel colours.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I've done brighter just so you can see exactly what I've done on screen. But if you picked a nice pastel pink, pastel blue, a nice lemon or something, you could keep it all very calm in the background and then just keep your white then on top. So I've said enough on the matter. Any questions? Yes. Do you want to ask me anything?
Yeah. Does anyone have any questions on blending or any of these tools? And correct me if I'm wrong here, Alex, but I have a feeling our Tonic Tuesday sale this week is all on tools, isn't it?
Yes.
Oh,
so
I didn't
even
know that.
I have a feeling that a lot of these things are probably in the sale at the moment.
Well, I didn't even know.
And that wasn't even planned. That was just a thought that occurred to me as you started using this and Alex was searching and I can see his search on screen.
Right.
It just, oh, I wonder if. So have a look on the website, our Tonic Tuesday. So throughout April, we've had different sales.
We have.
Every week. And this one I know is all about tools. So I have a feeling you might find some or a lot of these things.
Excellent.
Available for a bit of a discount at the moment. So definitely check that out. I have a feeling Alex is popping a link in for you as we speak.
Oh, lovely.
And there we go. Thank you very much, Mr.
Brilliant.
Alex.
Brilliant.
You're welcome.
I better make a bit of room now, hadn't I?
So I'm trying to find that video that we did with the book of background. I can't life for me what it was for. Did we even release it?
I think we did.
Oh, well, we'll come back.
I think it was when you first started, Alex.
It wasn't long after I started.
No. Was it the Christmas tree stencil? Was it on that one?
I don't think it was a stencil.
No.
I think it was just a background.
Because I can see the colours as well.
It was red and green.
It was red and green, definitely.
Christmas trend. It was
Christmas trend.
That's what it was.
I'm on it.
Santa's workshop?
Yes. It was the stamps that came in now was the red and green because they were really bright poppy colours, weren't they?
Yes, they were.
There we are.
That was before my time.
Put this back in the bag.
I knew that.
There we are. See it? Put it back in the bag.
Yeah.
And it's ready for next time.
So Suzanne is saying that she uses the sponge for embellishment mousse and paste. Yeah, me too.
Absolutely.
All day, every day. But my favourite tool for that.
I gotta say, I use all the brushes and daubers for different things throughout my crafting
mm-hmm.
week because most of them come out.
That's it. Whenever we're making something with layers, if we are just, you know, adding that little tiny bit of ink down the edge of something, it'll be one of the daubers. Probably the flat topped one would be the one that I would go for, just to add that little bit of just to differentiate between the layers and things like that.
Absolutely. So hopefully, you know, you can see the difference
mm-hmm.
in some of these, but they are nice to try with all of them. So if you have all the tools, try for yourself mm-hmm. and see what effects you can get.
Like we say, pretty sure every time we come down here, we say, have a messy day.
Absolutely.
Play with what you've got. See what you end up with.
Yeah.
You know, it's just a sheet of card at the end of the day. If you really hate it, cut it down into a tiny little piece and use it as a tiny background somewhere.
Absolutely. There's another one now. Imagine now you were going to have a faux layer in the middle of your card. Mm-hmm. So you've put down a card blank. I know it's a bit wonky, but imagine it's not.
Isn't it? Maybe you like it a bit wonky. I always put a lot Absolutely. Of my sentiments on a wonk. I know you and Karen are not fans, but...
I like
the
trend
in the craft room.
I like them. But you know when you do it yourself and you think it's not quite right and it has to go back straight then.
Mm-hmm.
But if you put a piece of card in the middle, you've inked your piece of card then ready for another card. But you've also got a background that's ready for two cards you can make.
Mm-hmm. Two for the price of one.
Work smarter, not harder.
We love a two for the price of one.
We do. We definitely do.
So Aisha has said, I have all my embellishment mousses that come with the kits and I don't use them as I have no idea what to do with them. Oh,
Aisha?
That pains me physically. It really does. There are so many things to do with mousse.
That's in our next craft clinic.
We'll do a guide to that next.
Yeah, maybe Alison will come down and give you a whole guide on mousses and pastes. And
maybe me, all of the maybe Leo.
Maybe me, maybe Karen. We know Karen loves that messy stuff. It's watching, so I'm literally throwing her under the bus. Hi, Karen.
The dunk.
Let's have a look. So Sue is saying that it's the bristle brushes that she doesn't use as she finds the other brushes and daubers better for my uses. And that's fine. We all craft completely differently. If a bristle brush, if you don't like the texture that gives you, that's absolutely fine. Try putting it in some mousse and dragging it down the paper so you actually get that intentional texture
that's
in
nice.
It.
That's nice. That is nice. I will say as well, you know, I've got a bit of arthritis in my hands. I find I've got to put a bit more pressure onto the bristle brushes than I have on these brushes. So maybe that will make a decision for mm-hmm. you as well. I'm not putting that much pressure that is hurting me, but I can feel that I'm putting a little bit more. So maybe that will make your decision as well. These are very smooth.
Oh, Melina has just said that she could finally afford the Tim Holtz glass mat. Oh, I am so pleased for you. It is a tool that none of us could live without. We have them everywhere.
And we know from experience today that is very durable.
So we have a camera right above us, which is obviously giving you all of the beautiful overhead shots that you see here. And as we were setting up for my lovely shimmer powder little videos that we did earlier, Alex was fiddling with this camera and literally a chunk of camera mounting apparatus fell and hit the centre of the glass mat. Absolute bullseye. And it is still intact. There was not a mark on it. There's literally nothing. So
I have seen Rich drop test these from upstairs on the mezzanine floor downstairs
to the warehouse.
To check, and it's all in packaging, to check if we send them out to you that they are okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we don't just think, oh, that'll be fine. We test it, too.
We really do. We drop camera equipment on them and everything just to make sure they're going to be perfect for you. But I'm very glad that you have one. I couldn't live without my glass mat.
I love it.
We've got more than one down here. We've got white ones and black ones. We've got them upstairs on all of our desks.
Absolutely.
They are brilliant.
That's the first thing that is clear, doesn't it, is the glass mat.
Mm-hmm. That is my workspace. The rest of my desk might have stuff on it, but as long as my glass mat is free, I can still craft.
Yeah. By the end of the day, it can crunch us in and we're on that square then.
That's all we've got. And then Friday afternoon, it all moves back up again.
Oh, it does. It does. Always a clean on a Friday.
Best part of the week. Karen says she thinks not. We're apparently not going under the bus for the Mooses video. I just saw someone say they're looking forward to that. Who said, yes, please? Oh, Valerie, there we go. So
excellent.
I think Valerie is saying she would like a mousse video.
Nice.
And I think that's something that I would like to do or we would like to do.
Yeah.
Because we have a lot of different textures and finishes and we should probably go through them.
I think we should.
We should.
That's the job for us next week.
Oh, wow.
Well, when I come in, Rick, Sal, don't be overly ambitious.
I didn't say it was going to be filmed next week. I said we'll think about it next week.
We'll make notes.
Leo shorthand.
Take a note, please, Miss Jones.
Absolutely.
That is my role. One of my roles upstairs, yes.
But we usually all craft in, and then we'll have an idea, and Leo's usually first to the pen to write it down.
I've always got a notebook to the side, but I'm a list maker. That is me. I love a list. So there's always a notebook and pen to the side of me. So yeah, it's just a quick one. Yeah, I've got that.
Because we forget it. You know, if you don't say there and then, by next week, I've totally forgotten what I said.
By the next hour. I was going to say the next day, but by the next hour, probably optimistic, all three of us have forgotten by that point. Okay.
What are we doing next question.
This one is from Christine Greenhorn on YouTube, and she's saying, do you have a foolproof way of heat embossing? I always end up with stray powder everywhere. And I think we all do, really.
I definitely do. Yeah. That's why we've thrown Leo under the bus for this one.
Yes, you'll notice that I've taken this question.
I gotta say, if you want to learn how to do this heat embossing, Leo is the best I have
seen. Don't set me up to fail now, Al. Really don't. Don't hype this up too much. If it comes out brilliantly, then you can hype it. But if it doesn't, then we'll just let it slide.
I think my problem is I don't take enough time about it.
Okay.
So, you know, I want it done and dusted and ready for the next part of my card. And I don't take enough time. So maybe that is a top tip from me.
Maybe
that'll be your top tip.
More patience.
I know.
So, my first top tip, I am going to use a stamp platform. In case you don't get your clear mark exactly right in the first time, if there's not enough on one side and not the other, you're never going to get that to stamp again a second time unless it is on a platform.
Absolutely.
So first tip is going to be that. I have my lovely bit of Tim Holtz Media Grip in the bottom because we love how this stops a card moving. You probably don't even need the magnets. But
probably don't.
We'll do it anyway.
Belt and braces though, isn't it?
Yeah. I just looked at some of the stamps that I have on my desk. I have a lot of stamp clubs on my desk. I can't think why. So this is just what I had, and I'm going to stamp some writing, which is probably the thing people struggle with the most, I would say. And I'm going to go for the word smart.
Nice.
Yeah. Okay. So a couple of things I'm going to say. First of all, try and handle your card as little as possible. Any of the oils that you've got on your hands and things like that are going to transfer to your card, and your embossing powder is going to want to stick to that. Anything tacky on your card is going to be a magnet for that embossing powder. So handle it, first of all, as little as possible. If you have...
wash your hands first?
Yeah, definitely. Clean hands, especially if you're using white card, always clean hands. You don't end up with a fingerprint on your... Beautiful.
Guess who's done that?
All of us.
Me.
All of us. This is why crystal drops are invented, I am sure of it, to cover up fingerprints. That's my thing and I'm sticking to it. So yeah, wash your hands first of all. Hand your card as little as possible. If you're embossing onto something that you have die cut and you've used a bit of low-tack tape to run it through.
Oh, yes.
Get your nice clean eraser that we all have in our craft rooms that are not for rubbing out pencils, and rub out your glue marks from your low-tack tape, because again, your embossing powder is going to want to stick to that. If you have one, your little embossing buddies, or your little cornstarch bags or whatever, and that's literally all this is. It's just a little cotton bag that is filled with cornstarch.
Yeah.
And you just literally wipe it a couple of times over your cardstock. It's going to take away if there's any static on there, any greasy marks, anything like that. It's just going to help pick that up for you. And then we stamp. So, pick up my stamp. I have my clear mark here.
I'm taking note here.
I'm going to make sure I've got this nicely inked, because ideally I don't want to do this a second time. Do we have any plain copier paper anywhere?
Oh, I haven't got a copy of paper, but I've got a piece of card.
That'll do, if you could fold a crease in it for me.
I will.
Thank you very much. So, I'm going to put this down. Do you want
a bigger piece?
That'll be fine. Don't press too hard with your stamp once you've got your clear mark on there, because you don't want it to squidge. Mm. Especially if you are doing text, you don't want it to squeeze out of the edges and distort your word. So, I have my clear mark on here. Here we go. I'm going to grab some embossing powder, and I just grabbed a couple of colours that were going to show up. So I think this is strawberry slush.
Nice.
Okay, let's go. Chuck that on there. Give it a tap. Pour out the excess and give it another tap from there. So this is what I've got so far.
Shall I be your assistant?
Thank you very much, my assistant. So it has stuck and I've actually not got any excess around here, which is ridiculous. So all of those tips work. Ta-da! The end. No. But I have what everyone likes to really joke about in the craft room, which is my, literally a two bristle brush. I don't know whose brush this is. When I moved in upstairs, I found this brush somewhere, and it is a very fine brush. I mean, there's probably not a lot more than two bristles in that. I don't know if you can even see.
There's not a lot in there.
This one, yeah, no, it's tiny. This one, every camera, it's and a tiny brush.
What if I got something dark to go behind it?
Maybe, but it's just a really teeny
what
tiny
about
little paintbrush. Can you see?
Don't even know if you can see that. No.
It's two bristles, let's call it that. And all I would do at this point, if I had any stray powder around the outside, I would go in and just very gently brush any excess off around the edges, tap it back over my little excess sheet, my pour-off sheet, and that would be it. I would then emboss. I don't actually have any today, so clearly the cornflour bag has worked a treat for me today.
My tip with that would be, don't get a brush with long bristles.
No, you want a short brush because you want the control.
Yes.
If you have long bristles, they are going to accidentally ping into the middle of the embossing pad. You want to stay there and drag half of it away.
And you've got to do it again.
And then you've got to start over because there's no way you can then re-mark over embossing powder.
No.
That's not going to work. So those are my tips. That's how I do it.
So if you've got an old brush that hasn't got many bristles in, you could cut it down.
Yeah, chop it down. Give it a go. Should we heat this just to prove I'm not making this up? Like I would normally at this point, I would probably be here for like 10 minutes, you know, tapping it, brushing it, tapping it, just to make sure. And it's worked perfectly first time. So I absolute fluke, I promise. The other thing I am going to do is I am going to heat this first of all from underneath, just so I don't blow all of the powder off to start off with.
You sometimes get a smoother result heating underneath, don't you?
No, speak up.
Yeah, speak up.
Wow, it's the same.
Try to mind.
Speak up. If you heat from the top, it seems to from underneath, it seems to be a smoother embossing powder. You sometimes get a little bit pitted if you heat from the top.
So
now
here we go. So there is my word emboss. I do have a little bit missing in the M. So if I was doing this for something, I probably would do this a second time and restamp it. But that was probably just because I was chatting.
Yeah.
And my clear mark dried ever so slightly. So there we go. Hopefully you can read that I am one smart cookie.
But there's lots of advice you've given there if you are struggling with embossing.
And it's really that easy. So take your time.
Yeah.
And just think carefully about your steps before you tip the powder. I hope that helps.
I've taken note.
Okay.
There we are. Let's pop a lid on you.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
There we go. Should I put that over here or are you all right?
No, that's fine. I've got a bit of space here. So, Susanna says she has baby powder. Yeah, exactly. Baby powder would work as well. It's a nice, fine powder, talc, anything like that is going to...
Check your baby powder hasn't got any oils in it, though.
Yes, you don't want anything that's got additives.
No.
You just want something that's going to absorb any greases or oils or anything that are on the surface of the paper.
Because there's some with lavender oil and things in, isn't there?
Definitely don't want that.
No,
that. That's not going to help you, unfortunately.
You can sprinkle that on after you've finished your card and it'll make your card smell gorgeous.
Mm-hmm.
Cornflour is another one.
Yes, and probably you've got that in the cupboard already.
Yeah, the so one upstairs just, is probably about 5 years out of date from my kitchen.
Nice.
But we're not eating it, so it doesn't matter.
No, exactly. And if you don't have one of these stitched little bags, if you just have an old hanky, put some in, elastic band around the top.
Pop socks I used to put it in.
That works too. A
couple of pairs of pop socks.
Yeah, any of those is going to help you. So yeah, those are my top tips. I hope
so
that
you
has helped.
A question there, now.
No.
No, I was waiting for Leah. I left the comments to Leo.
Who's left fingerprints on their cards? I mean, I think every single crafter has at some point an ink smudge, or we've stamped a sentiment and touched it a bit too soon. But this is why we have butterflies and small flowers in die sets. It's why we have things like crystal drops and sequins. All of these things cover up a multitude of sins. Yeah, absolutely.
Crafters, little helpers. We all need them.
Mother's little helpers, yeah, exactly. So Sue says that she has a brush similar to a makeup brush. There you go, exactly.
Doesn't matter what the brush is.
No, any old tiny one. Dead brush would do at this point. Snip your bristles down if they're a bit too long.
I'm wondering about those brushes that you put eyeliner on with.
Oh, yes, maybe.
Because they're quite small, aren't they?
And they're quite stiff normally, those kind of brushes as well. They're not soft. You don't want a soft, flexible brush for this. You want quite a stiff brush. It's a very specific thing. You'll know it when you see it. You don't want your bristles moving too far and hitting the bit of embossing powder you want to stay there.
That may be my problem, that I'm using a brush that's too long.
Maybe. I've done that before.
There we are. Yeah. I've learnt something too. Pinch Leo's brush.
I might have to stick my name on it now. There it is, yeah. Leo's brush, hands off.
Exactly. Exactly.
Melina is saying that's why she does junk journal books. She just pretends all the mess is part of the book.
Absolutely. Perfect. Nice bit of distressing. Love it.
Absolutely. It is all intentional. There are no mistakes in crafting.
There's not.
Just excuses to embellish.
There's not.
And Casey in CA says that ladybugs work great as well.
Yes. I'm going to ask you another question. It's like 20 questions tonight, isn't it? Do you have any questions for next month's craft clinic?
Is there anything that you would like to see us go through in depth up here? Any specific dilemmas that you have? Anything you'd like us to go over? Anything you've seen today that you'd like us to discuss a bit more?
Have we missed anything? We're always happy to kind of help you with your problems.
Absolutely. That's what our craft clinic is for.
We were beginners at one point, and I would have loved someone to come and sort my problems out. Too many of them, I think.
Isn't that why I was employed?
Sorry, problems. Yes.
Oh,
absolutely. You know you're my carer.
I am, absolutely. And she's my mammy.
Oh, I'll be mammy any day.
You'll be mammy today.
I will be.
My lovely wife has just called me out. She said that didn't you leave nail varnish marks recently? So yes, when I wear bright red and like a dark crimson kind of colour nail varnish, and I'm sure I'm not the only one this happens to, it kind of leaves streaks on your white cardstock sometimes if you accidentally, so embellish all over that.
Absolutely.
Or don't paint your nails, but that would be boring.
Maybe not with red.
I've done it. I like to live dangerously.
On the edge.
Can you help me find the Teflon bone folder? Oh, I can see Alex on the case on that one for you there, Casey. So I have a feeling you'll have a link in chat momentarily.
Oh.
Alison is the mammy and Leo is a sister.
Karen
is... We say this and probably no one's going to believe this. So between Alison and Karen, there are 8 years. And then between Karen and I, there are another 8 years.
Yeah.
We are perfectly positioned between
each other. And I'm the oldest.
And I'm the baby. I don't feel like it a lot of the time at the moment, honestly. I'm so forgetful. It's ridiculous.
Karen's our Aunt Diva dancing on the tables at a family party.
She is, yes. She's the one we don't talk about.
Oh, we do. We talk
I
about Karen
the
a lot.
Nicest possible.
But you always have that crazy person in your family that, you know, they come to functions and they do the thing and you're just like, yeah, that's just crazy Karen in the corner.
That's what I'm planning to be when I retire.
Absolutely. I've always said, I don't want to grow up. No.
My son says to me, you know, you see that, I can't remember what you see on Facebook, it's one of those little wordy things. Oh God, what's she doing now? He said, that's you, Mum, he said, because I don't know what you're going to do next.
Oh dear.
But you've got to keep him on
his toes.
Is
it a meme? Is that what we're talking about?
I think it might be, a wordy thing.
A wordy thing. A meme, yes.
Yes, that's it.
One of those.
One of those old grannies and you think, oh, they're skateboarding down the street. You never know, I may not do the skateboard, but there's other things I can do.
Growing old disgracefully is what I always
absolutely.
Like to say.
Yes. Absolutely.
My mum always said that and I'm definitely following in her footsteps. Cindy has joined us from Springboro in Ohio, so welcome.
Hello.
Cindy, I hope you're having a lovely afternoon, evening.
Mm.
Somewhere around there probably.
I don't know, Ohio. And tell us.
Yeah.
What's the time of year?
Are you crafting today? Do you have anything going on? We are almost 7, I think we're time apparently. So Lizzie has asked a question. Can you show us how to do watercolour backgrounds with the Aquaflow pens? Well, yes.
We'll give it a go.
We will give it a go. We will try some things. We'll have another messy day upstairs and see all of the different things we can do with Aquaflows, and we shall bring that for next
craft clinic.
I think that one's you and Karen. So, Karen, you're up.
Get your inky bits out, Karen.
What would be easier to for you to just do it, or for you to teach Karen how to do it?
Oh no, I'm hands off on this one. No, like Karen, honestly, we joke that she doesn't like using the messy stuff.
She does.
She absolutely does, and so does Al. Absolutely. So
we all use all the stuff, don't we?
We all do all of it. Yes. We might be ever so slightly niched down here, but upstairs we all do a bit of everything. And Cindy says she is crafting today. Fantastic. I hope you're having a wonderful crafty afternoon then.
That is lovely.
Shall we get on to our last question? We've definitely saved the messiest to last.
We have.
Yes, we're going to have some fun. We have, Sharon's just asked a question. I've got it down by here, fine. So Sharon has said, do you need to use watercolour card when you want to make a watercolour background? That's a brilliant question.
I think it depends on your card.
Yeah, and kind of the effect that you're looking for.
We'll do a few different backgrounds on different cards.
I think the simple answer is no.
Yeah.
But you're going to get a different effect with different types of cardstock.
Yes, definitely.
But we'll definitely circle back to that one. We'll stick that one on the list for next time, and we can show some different...
Have a little play.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so our last question then.
It's all to do with absorbency of the paper and things, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. So our last question was from, and I hope I'm pronouncing this right now, it's from Daily01 on YouTube. And this one is, my question is about mica mist not spraying and clogging. What tips can you give to prevent this occurring? And this is a fairly common question, I would say. So our lovely mica mist, I've brought two down with me. I'm just going to pop them in here. So we have, I brought two of these colours down because they show things a bit differently. So this blue one, you can see, is still nicely blue. And if I give it a swirl, you're going to be able to see all of the mica in there straight away. Whereas this red one, you can see, has separated ever so slightly. So you have your mica and your pigment suspended in this liquid. And it does settle. And this is partly where you're going to be getting that sort of clogging and issue spraying from. So my first tip is always going to be, before you use it, do not spray it if you have this thick layer at the bottom.
Yeah.
Because all that's going to happen is you're going to suck all of that mica up the tube and you will clog the nozzle. So you're going to need to give it a very vigorous shake at this point. But this looks good because I'm going to make sure that
it looks amazing.
If I just stop for a second and hopefully I'll get the mica swirl in there.
That's lovely, isn't it?
Whenever we've got mica mist on, it doesn't matter what show we're on, we've always got
You've
got
to give it a swirl.
You've got to. So I'm going to keep going with this. In fact, if you could keep my lovely assistant, I shall grab in the box.
And you can hear there's a little ball bearing in here as well that is helping to mix it. We're not bad there now, I
Get
think.
In there. Good. Yeah. I have one of our old shipping boxes on the front of here.
Well-used shipping box, isn't it?
Yes, it is well-used. And whenever we're using these kinds of messier things that spritz and spray everywhere, we tend to do it within a box just to try and contain the mess. And Alex is looking a bit nervousy now because I've got his iPad to the side of me. I've got mica mist out on the desk now. So
if you can see the bottom there, if I hold that, all that mica now is all mixed in. There is nothing stuck on the bottom there.
See you there. Keep it at that angle, Al.
Yeah.
There you go.
You can see you well there.
All right.
So that's going to be the first tip. Whenever you start to use it, make sure it is thoroughly shaken. You definitely don't see any of that Not stirred, yes. I mean, you don't see any sediment at the bottom of the bottle. And then I'm going to put this in here and just give it a spritz. Make sure we can see. The only problem with the red one is if I don't aim this correctly, it's going to look a little bit like a crime scene. This is my Dexter moment, is what I'm going to say here. So I'm going to give this a bit of a spray.
It's all water-based as well, just in case you're worrying about using it with children and things. It's totally water-based.
So as soon as you have finished using your mica mist, not just once you've sprayed it once, but once you've done with your mica mist session, shall we say, you're going to want to unscrew your nozzle from the end of here and take this over to the sink. His face.
He's like this.
Please don't tip. Yeah, take your nozzle over to the sink and give it a thorough rinse. So, like, sit it in a cup of water, spray it through to get all of that mica up and out through the nozzle. Make sure it's completely clean. Put it back in the bottle. One of the things that I have seen a lot of people say is they actually store it on its side. Right. That way the mica settles to the side of the bottle, not the bottom, so that the tip of the nozzle isn't sat in mica. So it's not in the end, first of all. But yeah, definitely shake first, rinse afterwards.
Yeah.
And if you have any real issues, we do also sell spare nozzles.
Yeah, we do.
And you'll very often see when we put these products into bundles and things, we will always add in the spare nozzles for you as well. But I love them. I love the shimmer that these give.
And it's a very subtle effect.
It is, it is. I'm going to give you just a... I've got the blue here.
We Oh, you've got to do it.
We might as well. Just give it a quick shake.
Jubilees come in. We'll have a bit of red, white and blue.
Well, it's funny that you should mention that these are the two colours that we have. Because, yes, we've been doing some red, white and blue projects, haven't we? So let's give this a little... There we go. How patriotic we all feel now, don't we?
But you could put a die cut on top of that as well, couldn't you? So you've got a sprayed die cut and you've got a stenciled area then.
Two for the price of one.
We're talking about that a lot tonight.
It's a good thing. If you can do, you know, get two pieces for products out of one thing, absolutely. I have something that I did in the Shimmer Powder video earlier that is definitely a two for one. And you're going to have to watch that video to find that one.
It's
one of my favourites.
To see all these gorgeous samples that are around me here.
So there we go. I hope, Daily, that that answers your question.
But what if you've got a bottle and you can't get a spray?
Well, thanks, Mammy, for reminding me because I'd forgotten.
Shall I give you one of these?
Yeah, we probably should. Oh, watch Alex's face now.
Alex is going to be like this. Oh, no.
So I have a couple of paintbrushes here. So if you have clogged the nozzle... and you can't, you know, unblock it no matter what you do. Do we have any messy mats down here? Any media grip, don't
no,
we?
But I've got another sheet of cards.
There we have. Do you?
Oh,
I don't know, it's fine. Go for it. Another bit of card. Do it. There we go. So, just in case you can't spray it at all ever, drop a little bit out onto... I would normally use one of my... the messy mats that come with your glass mats.
It's fine.
This will do. Pick it up with your paintbrush and then you can give yourself some nice brushed lines. And you're not going to see this probably from the distance. So I will do a little bit more. But you're going to get all of the shimmer and a little bit of the pigment, but in a different way. And you could paint stripes with this, you could fill in flowers, you could probably actually paint with it if you really wanted to. So you're still going to get all of that shimmer.
Got to wait till it dries though, I've known that's the only thing.
You're getting a bit of it. Let me see if I can, without knocking the bottle over that's got a nice loose cap on
yes,
it.
Yes, please.
Oh, no.
It would be our dresses that would be first and we're both in our nice dresses today. So we would be leaping backwards. But yes, you can get... a little bit of
mica
shimmer.
But again, you could use your sponges, any of your brushes, again, with this product.
Exactly. And the other thing that you can do that I am definitely not going to do is you can do your splatter technique. So where you've got a nice big puddle, pick it up on your paintbrush, tap it onto something over your project and just give that little splatter. So it's the same effect as if you were spritzing it from the spray bottle. You're just picking it up with a paintbrush and doing it that way instead.
I like a splatter.
Yes, but I think probably Alex might have a heart attack if we...
Oh, I think so. Without a box, without the aid of a spray booth.
A spray booth, yes.
I think exactly. Alex would worry.
Yeah, particularly with that camera so close to you. It's the cameras I'm more worried about than anything else. Simon would flip his lid.
He probably would.
No, indeed. There we go. So I hope that has answered all of the questions that these people... have sent in to us and that's given you what you were looking for. Let's have a quick look if we've had anything else. Had a question about the So Pretty butterflies and floral dyes. I purchased them based on card samples. When I received them, the sample cards were no longer posted on your site. Can they be posted again?
Ooh, maybe we can find a couple of them.
Yeah, so we'll have a look and see if we've got them upstairs. I'm sure we must still have the images somewhere. We will have a look. I'll get Alex to pin that question for me so we can come back to that.
Suicide. Or we stick them in the group.
Yes.
So
yes,
get into the Facebook group. If you're not in the Facebook group, get in the Facebook group.
Yes, pop your questions in there and we can then come back to them.
It's just the Tonic the official Tonic Studios
Facebook group. Yeah, that's it. Casey says this, they use the Tonic magnetic sheets for the storage binders to straighten out her cardstock after it warps. That is such a good idea.
That's good.
Brilliant.
That is good.
Because, of course, the two magnets are going to suck together.
Definitely.
What a smart plan.
Well, excellent.
I like that idea. I might borrow that. Thank you for that one.
Or your cutting boards or something. Underneath your cutting boards.
Yes, indeed.
And even, if you've got cutting boards that are a little bit bowing, on the weekend we pop them underneath our machines.
Yep, under the tangerine they go.
Storing them, and then they're ready then for the next time.
Exactly. Beverly has said, will you bring clear back? I presume clear mark is what you're referring to there. So it is included in, I think it's the principal inks. You get black shadow, metro grey, and clear mark in that one.
Yeah.
So that would be your minis, the diamonds, aren't they? The little one. So I know the clear mark is definitely included in that if we don't have the big one on the website anymore. Principal inks, is that what it's called?
I think so.
There we go.
Alex is on the case.
Jinx, wow. We clearly spend far too much time together.
We definitely do. I'm trying to see any more questions there.
So Sue says it doesn't matter what brand, that the nozzles still clog. So she's bought an extra small bottle. So if that's working for you, Sue, then absolutely keep doing that. Honestly, I'm going to full disclosure. Last time we used these was probably a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
We didn't rinse our nozzles. We're not good crafters. Do as we say, not as we do. And I picked them up off the shelf and spritzed them today just to make sure they worked and they were fine.
But I think the difference is we can go down to the warehouse and get another sample.
Pick up another one, I know.
It's not as easy for you. This is why we give these tips.
Yeah,
so that we can prevent you having problems.
But Sue said that she loves the sprays and so do the grandchildren, and we have to use them outside or everything is covered despite the box. I mean,
I don't blame the box
gathers most of the overspray, but I'm sure we've probably spritzed a little bit of the desk. But I can see shimmer powder run off over there and all kinds of other things, so I don't think that's
As you do.
So that was all of our questions for this week. Anything that you've asked that we've not been able to answer today, we will definitely...
We'll have a read through everything because we may well have missed bits.
Yeah.
If there's anything we can answer next month, then we will. If you have a question and you haven't asked it already, pop it in the comments below. Don't forget, tell us your favourite card sizes.
Yes, on that poll, that's on the official Facebook group that I think Alex has very kindly posted in the comments for you.
Excellent.
As well.
Excellent.
Yeah, I've just seen on Facebook now, six people have just requested to be part of it for the first time. So.
Oh, lovely.
Amazing.
Come and join us
on our group. We are doing a lot more on there recently.
Absolutely.
You might start seeing a little behind the scenes bits and pieces coming up on there.
So you'll see Crafty Leo, Crafty Alison, and Karen Tonic on there.
Yep, she's around too.
She is around.
You'll start seeing us a little bit more regularly on there. So definitely join our Facebook group. It's where we love to see everything that people are making.
And we've seen lots of gorgeous projects.
There have been some amazing projects. I think we're going to bring some to the weekend or on Friday.
Yeah, there's some... and it's where we go for exclusive behind the scenes stuff, and even some stuff from the craft room where these two and Karen don't clean up what they shouldn't be showing you. So you might get a little sneak peek of stuff that's coming out in the future.
If we're testing something and it's on our desk, I forgot to put that away.
There's a board behind me as well.
And there's shelves behind me. So just, if you're ever watching one of those videos, if you ever see a front on of me, have a look what's behind me.
Sue loves a sneak peek. Sue was always, years ago when we did an awful lot of these things, Sue would always find the product on the internet first.
Yeah, absolutely.
Wouldn't you, Sue? Answer me correctly. She'd be saying, where's this coming? When are we having this? That was always Sue.
Yeah, and there's always sneak peeks to be seen in our room. Even if we put stuff away, there's bound to be something.
We always forget something,
Always. So, yeah, join the group. Join us there. You'll be seeing a lot more from us happening on there.
You certainly will.
Thank you, though, for joining us this evening. It's been lovely to have you here with us in the basement on our new craft clinic time. I hope it's been a good time for you. Do let us know if you prefer this time or if the sort of Monday morning was better. You know, we are still looking to see what works best for most
people. We're still having a bit of a jiggle around,
aren't
we?
Exactly. So if this is...
We want to find what's best for us, but also best for you.
Absolutely. So do join us again. Make sure, like I said already, if you're not already subscribed to our YouTube channel, make sure you do. Hit the notification bell so that any of these videos that we've discussed today, as soon as they go live, you will know about it. Don't forget to tag us in your makes as well. We love to see what
you're
up to.
That's the most important.
Yeah.
Tell us what you were doing.
And put them in the group.
Put them in the group.
Share with everybody. Crafters love to see what other crafters are making.
So even you'll get our inspiration.
Absolutely. Even if you think, oh, I'm not sure about it, put it in the group. Share it.
Absolutely. Yeah, have a great evening, everyone, and we hope to see you again very soon.
Happy crafting.